Hey guys, let's talk about the best folding electric bikes on the market right now. Since 2012, I've covered about 118 different models that fit into this category, but I haven't covered them all. I do read the comments. Please let me know if there's something I've missed or something new, or just if you disagree, and then other people can kind of see that as well and sort through. Back at the site, I've got a whole category. You can see all the different reviews that I've done. Each one has like a 30-minute video, all the specs. There's a great comparison tool, and there are forums. So you can see what actual owners say. You know, I only have these bikes for a day or two in most cases, and I do my best, but my goal is to actually help you. So with that said, let's jump right in. So first up is the premium selection. This one is like, if price is less of an issue for you, I recommend the GoCycle GS. Now, it's a bit ironic because they do have a GX, a G3. They have even more expensive bikes up to that like $4,500 price range, but this one's $2,800. And what really makes these bikes special is, first of all, GoCycle only makes folding electric bikes. Their founder was a design engineer at McLaren, which is a sports car company. Think like Ferrari or Lamborghini. I mean, this guy, he knows his stuff, and he's created something really special. Like, you just look at the bike and it's different. The body is magnesium, it's lightweight, it has a fully enclosed chain, and that chain is not gonna fall off. It's super tight. That's something I think about, because when you're folding, you lay the bike on its side, maybe it's in a rattly, bumpy kind of position in your car, your plane, or whatever the situation is. So they've got that solved, but you also have gears. It has a 3-speed internally geared hub in the rear. They put the motor up front. It's not the most powerful thing, but it's pretty efficient. It does create a little bit of noise, but you know, most of these bikes have some sort of trade-off. So I feel like with GoCycle, they're going for something lightweight and clean and sleek looking, and they really nail it. The battery's built into the frame. Again, lightweight here. They do have these perfectly matched fenders. They have optional bags. They have lights and stuff. So you can really go nuts with this thing. And in addition to pedal assist, it has a little trigger throttle, which is cool. As with most of the bikes on this list, this only comes in one frame size, but the seat sort of angles back and it telescopes up and it goes pretty high. So if you're someone who's tall, you can still fit on this and it's gonna extend your reach as it extends your pedal stroke length. A couple other things I like about this bike is the reflective sidewalls on those tires, just to keep you visible and safe, because you are on a folding bike. They tend to be lower to the ground. And if you're actually traveling with this, you're in a new place, it's just good to be visible so you don't get, you know, hit by a car or something. I also like the comfort that it offers. So these tires, they're a little bit higher air volume. And if you think about the smaller tire diameter, they run into things. You get that higher attack angle versus like a nice big tire that has a higher air volume, a lower attack angle. So keep that in mind with any of the bikes on this list. I also like that they've got like a little suspension element up front. It's not great, but it's better than nothing. And then there's this little bumper suspension in the back. Good option. And it's a great company in my opinion. Next up is the best value folding electric bike. And for this, I chose the Magnum Classic. And this is a folding electric bike that comes with a traditional suspension fork, a suspension seat post, still has, you know, medium volume tires with reflective sidewall stripes, but this one comes with fenders and it comes with lights. It's got a 500 watt planetary geared hub motor and a nice removable battery pack. It's called a Silverfish. So it's kind of this traditional pack that you could find even if Magnum went out of business or something. You could have this repacked at a company like FT Power in California. To me, that's something I think about. You know, how modular is this? Looking at GoCycle, their stuff's all really custom. The battery's in the frame. It looks beautiful. If you kind of go the other way, you're like, well, what can I do myself? Like, how fixable is this myself? You definitely get more of that with the Magnum here. You still get a trigger throttle, you get cadence sensing pedal assist, you get a cassette versus that 3-speed internally geared hub. So it's not quite as fancy, but you get more gears and it just kind of works. Now it has mechanical disc brakes and spoked rims if you get the Magnum Classic, which is about $1,000 less than the GoCycle. But if you want, you can upgrade to the Magnum Premium, which has hydraulic disc brakes. Great if you have smaller hands or maybe you're wearing gloves like I am today. And that one also has cast magnesium rims, which gives it a little bit more strength if you're someone who's a bit larger, heavier. I see a lot of people buy folding electric bikes just because they're approachable, the frame's smaller, and they're like, yeah, I like that. I feel like I, you know, have control over the bike. Now, again, it's not nearly as light as the GoCycle, but you're saving $1,000 and you're getting a little bit more power, and you know, you also have the dealers and stuff. Magnum does a great job in that way, and that's why I feel comfortable recommending them. So next we have the best affordable folding electric bike. And for this, I chose the Saunders Smart Step. It's an approachable step through frame. It's full size, so you get that nice leg extension, and it's just a little bit more comfortable to ride for extended periods of time. It also has higher air volume and that lower attack angle, so 27.5 by 3 inch tires, plus size tires, as well as a suspension fork. So it's gotta be one of the most comfortable folding electric bike out there. Saunders also has like a fat tire folding electric bike if you're, you know, if you wanna do that. So to see a company that has two folding models that are so different, but each offer something special, I think that's really cool. And for people who want a full bike experience, but they want that low price point, $1,000, that's not too bad. Now, doesn't come with the lights, doesn't come with the fenders. It's not quite as portable. It's also a little bit heavier. And you're getting a little bit of a smaller motor with this, 350 watts. So it's kind of an energy sipper. And this is a direct-to-consumer only bike. So unlike Go Cycle or Magnum, where you could go into a shop and get some support, you're a little bit more on your own. You got to unbox this and deal with some of the trash, and then you've got to kind of build it up and get it straightened out. But still, for $1,000, I think this is an excellent choice. And I trust Saunders now. They've been around for a while. They've done these crowdfunded electric bikes, and this is the affordable pick. So I think this one or some of their other folding options are worth considering. Next up is the promoted folding electric bike. So the way I run the site is I cover a bunch of bikes, and if I feel like a company's doing a good job, I'll say, hey, you can pin that to the top of the category, one bike per category, and I'll mention you on these videos. But I only do this for bikes that I actually liked and companies that I trust. And that is the case here. We're talking about Blix, and this is their Vika Plus folding electric bike. This is probably the most beautiful folder on this list. It's very classic. It's got this British racing green color scheme that goes all the way through the fenders. It's got these beautiful like faux leather brown grips and saddle that tie in very nicely. All of the other accents like the spokes, the handlebar, the stem, the crank arms, the chainring is all silver. So it's really nice. And this bike has kind of everything you need. It's got a little rack for the back. You can carry panniers or a trunk bag. It's got those fenders and it's got lights, integrated lights that run off the battery. The battery is pretty high capacity and it's modular. So Blix has a number of electric bikes and the battery will work with kind of any of them, which is nice if you get like a his and hers or, you know, a couple family members end up with these things. They also sell through shops, but with Blix, it's a showroom experience. So you can test ride the bike and you can touch it. You can get accessories and stuff like bags, maybe a child seat, a helmet, but then you order directly from Blix and it's drop shipped to you and the shop gets a commission. So it's sort of a hybrid model. And what you don't have with this bike is a suspension fork or suspension seat post. The tires are pretty good. They've got reflective sidewall stripes, but they're a little bit more traditional in size. They don't have knobs and they aren't like higher volume. So you are gonna get that higher attack angle, but you're gonna save some efficiency. You're not gonna have as much drag and it's not gonna weigh as much. So for me, this bike offers a lot of value and it's just beautiful. The price point isn't too bad at roughly $1,600. Back at the site, there's a map tool where you can search the brand or location and it'll show you dealers nearby. So hopefully there's one you can check out and give this thing a test ride sometime. Last up is the honorable mention. This didn't place in the other categories and it's a bit unique, kind of like the Saunders, you know, Smart Step. That's a full size folding electric bike. This one's a fat tire folding electric bike. So it might not be applicable. You don't need to force yourself into this. Fat tires tend to make a little bit more noise. They add a little bit more weight. They do add some stability and comfort, but the size is just gonna be bigger. And this is a folding bike. It might not be right for you. So this is the Rad Power Bikes Rad Mini. And I chose the step through, but they also have a high step version. Keep that in mind. I like this bike because the battery is modular. It fits with all the other Rad Power bikes. They have optional front racks and baskets and trays and stuff that are all cross compatible. But the bike itself, even if you don't do that, it comes with great fenders and they're wide enough. They're plastic. They're gonna keep you relatively dry and clean. And if you're going off-road with those fat tires, that's a nice thing. It also has integrated lights, just like the Blix Vika Plus that we mentioned before. And the lights, being on a smaller platform is great. It's just nice to be seen, stay visible. And their rear light is unique because it has like a flashing mode and a brake light mode. So it's just, it's a little bit of an upgrade. The tires have reflective sidewall stripes and they're puncture resistant, which is nice. The drivetrain is a 1x7, just like the Blix Vika Plus, but it has an 11 to 34 tooth instead of 14 to 28. So it's actually a wider gear ratio, which is really important since the bike weighs more and you might be doing some off-roading. The bike's very approachable. Step through frames have a little bit of frame flex, especially with extra weight, especially if you get that optional rear rack and you load it up. So keep that in mind. But overall, the bike's great. It's got a throttle, it's got cadence sensing pedal assist. It gets the job done. And even though Rad doesn't have a big network of dealers like Magnum or Go Cycle or Blix, it's kind of like Saunders in that you could order it online and get a box, but they also have these cool delivery vans that can kind of assemble and hand it off to you, make things a little bit easier that way. And they sell in the US, Canada, and parts of Europe. They do have a few flagship stores, so you might get lucky that way. Well, guys, I hope that helped you. The folding category is one of the most popular back at this site, and I can see why. You know, folding e-bikes are easier to store if you have limited space, or maybe you're someone who likes to travel, you've got an RV or a boat or a plane or just a car trunk, you wanna be able to fit it in there, and it keeps it cleaner than putting it on a car bike rack. And bike racks cost money. Maybe you need a hitch for your car if you wanna be able to support the weight of an e-bike. Still, there are some trade-offs. You can get a compact electric bike with a rigid frame. It won't flex maybe as much as the folding bike. Sometimes they weigh less as well. You can also get a full-size electric bike with like quick-release wheels, removable battery. There are lots of options, and I've created these like best e-bike lists for the top 11 categories back at electricbikereview.com. So again, check that out. Keep an eye on the channel. I'm doing reviews all the time. I love you guys. Ride safe. We'll see you in the next one.